All right, Aggie fans, the regular season is over. It is time for March Madness. So let's get you ready for the Big West Tournament. UC Davis comes in as a number 6 seed up here. You can see that in the tournament. The regular season, UC Irvine, well, they were dominant, 15-1. They ran away with the conference. They're the favorite going into the Big West Conference Tournament. There's no doubt about it. But for those of you who have been watching UC Davis hoops for the last several years, you know the Big West Tournament is wide open. In the last 8 years of the tournament, there's been 8 different tournament winners. That means 8 different teams have danced in March. UC Davis, how realistic are their chances here? They finished 6th in the regular season, 7-9 in the Big West Conference, just 11-19 overall. It was a disappointing year in terms of the victories. Aggies had higher expectations. It just did not work their way. But as we know, in March, everybody's record is 0-0. Everybody gets a clean slate. This Aggie team, well, they've got as good a chance as anybody to dance in March. And that's because of a lot of veteran players. They've got Siler Schneider back. He was on the NC2A tournament team from 2 years ago. Garrison Good, the same. TJ Shorts, a senior, one of the Big West players of the year from a year ago and made the Big West first team this year as well. He'll be in the tournament. So the Aggies have a lot of firepower. They'll be ready to go. But at the end of the day, it comes down to matchups. So in the first round, who are the Aggies playing? Well, they've got Cal State Fullerton on Thursday. That's a matchup of two teams that have played in the tournament in the last 2 years. The Aggies won a thriller back in 2017 in overtime. That took them into the final game against UC Irvine. They won that, and they went dancing in the big NC2A tournament 2 years ago. Now, last year, Cal State Fullerton paid back the Aggies. They won after being down by double digits in the second half, and a heartbreaking loss for the Aggies, 55-52. They then beat Irvine in the championship game. They were the representative from the Big West Conference in the NC2A last season. So this is kind of the rubber match on Thursday. Obviously, both schools have a lot of tradition. Cal State Fullerton has a lot of seniors as well. They've got a great backcourt combination in Kyle Allman and Ahmad. So they're going to be very tough to beat on Thursday. But certainly, the Aggies have a great opportunity to get the victory. As for the other quarterfinal games, you can see number 2 Santa Barbara kicks off the tournament. They play number 7 CSUN, that's Cal State Northridge, to lead off the tournament. Later in the day, the number 1 seed UC Irvine takes on number 8 UC Riverside. And the late game tonight, or on Thursday, it's Hawaii versus Long Beach State. So if the Aggies survive against Cal State Fullerton, the way the tournament works is they reseed the Aggies based upon who wins below and above them. They will determine the winner. But most likely, it'll be UC Irvine because the Aggies would most likely be the lowest seed available, which means they'd have to play the top seed in the tournament. And that would make it on a Friday game in the semifinals. And that would be a showdown because the Aggies and the Anteaters have been the two dominant programs in the Big West over the last 5 years. UC Irvine has now won 3 conference championships in the last 5 years. The Aggies have won 3 Big West Conference championships if you count regular season and postseason. So that would be an epic matchup. All of these games are on ESPN, and that would be an amazing semifinal game. And then, of course, the finals are on Saturday night. So the way this thing works, the Aggies have to win 3 games in 3 days, survive in advance, or lose or go home. That's March Madness. The Aggies have everything in front of them, but it won't be easy, of course. So hope you enjoy Aggie Hoops as we get here during March Madness. And of course, you can follow everything right here at Sports 1140.